What's up, guys? Welcome back to another episode of Hunger Games on the Mindplex server. Today we're gonna have two very, very exciting games of Hunger Games, and yeah, I'm gonna have a lot of fun playing. Hopefully you guys have a lot of fun watching me, and let's get into the first game. Okay, we have 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0, and the chests at spawn did not look like they had... I wasn't close enough to get them, so we are gonna head out into the map and try to get something. Now, we got ourselves a piece of armor, which isn't bad. We got ourselves an arrow, a bow, and a fishing rod, which are all pretty good. The fishing rod can help us if we go in water to escape, and that is actually an amazing find. That is a stone sword. That is end game weapon right there, so that is amazing. Let's try to hunt down this person right here, because that is just a walking chest, really. But it looks like this guy over here, oh, we're trapped. Oh, that's bad. There's a guy behind us, there's a guy in front of us, but it looks like we have managed to escape somehow. They just let me walk right out of there, which is a good thing, because I am not dead yet. So that's a good thing. Now, there are people over here, so I gotta be a little bit careful. Gotta be careful a little bit. So it looks like this guy is hitting from very far away. Now, that's... yeah, that's a little bit fishy. I'm not gonna lie, that is a bit fishy. Go back in that video and see his hits. He is hitting from quite a bit of ways. Not gonna be calling anything, though. Let's try to kill him, though. If he is hacking, well, then we're dead. Let's try to go for him. Hopefully, we don't die. The only good thing about anybody who has reach hacks or things like that is my special power actually pulls people in. So I can take care of those people a little bit of the time if they do not have a weapon. But hopefully this guy doesn't have a weapon, or let's just hope he isn't hacking. But let's try to go for him. It doesn't look... yeah, whoa, okay. That was a quick spin hit. I see you. Alright, see, we've gotten pretty close to him. This is our chance to take him out. But guys, look at these hits. These hits. Okay, you know what? I'm glad he's dead. I mean, look, and I'm not going to say anything, but if you go back in the video, those were some pretty fishy hits. Now, we're really high up on this mountain. I've actually never been here. I've played many hours on this map, and I've actually never been up here because I've never had a reason to. But yeah, guys, I don't know what's going on with that guy. Tell me your opinion in the comments. Do you think he was using some kind of external assistance? Or do you think he just kind of got really lucky and he kept hitting the combos and it looked like he was hitting from far away? I'm actually really wondering, because I tend to call it out real easily when I see... when it's at the point where I can't even get close to hitting you and you keep hitting me, I tend to just reach in the bucket and say hacks, but of course I don't always mean it. A lot of times I'm just joking about it, but that right there, I don't know, guys, tell me in the comments. But the important thing is, he's actually dead, so it doesn't matter what he had or what he didn't have, he is dead now. Let's continue our game, and hopefully we can go ahead and win. We do have some good armor on us, so we do have that advantage. We also do have a very powerful weapon on our hands. Most people during right now would probably have stone axes and probably wooden swords. Once we get down to about 7-8 people, I can kind of guarantee that most people will have stone swords, so we won't have an advantage. Some people will even have iron swords, iron axes, or dare I say a diamond sword. But that, you only see a diamond sword every like 10 to 20 games, really. Not even that. I haven't seen one in so many games. But two people are dead, so we only have 8 tributes left. We started with 24 or 25, so over 3/4 are dead. Now, the good thing is I am not one of them, which I'm very thankful for, that I am still living. So it seems like this guy dropped some armor here, but I do not need it, actually. If we take a look at my armor, we don't need any of that stuff. And I'm not going to even bother checking the chest, because if there's stuff lying around, whatever's in it is probably gone. Okay, so we have 7 people left. Polarized has killed Choco, which is exciting. Alright, let's keep looking for the chest. Now, most of these chests around here will be looted, so we have to go... oh, I am so sorry. I feel terrible about that. This person was sitting in here defenseless, minding their own business, and I just come in and destroy them. Oh, I feel bad. Alright, so now there is a drop coming in here. I don't know if we'll be able to get the stuff. There is a fight going on in here. Let's try to take this person out. Let's take him out. Come on, die, 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 die. Bam! And there's another person behind us, so let's get out of here. Ooh, that was a mosh pit of death. I think at least two or three people died, and he's still behind me. Let's keep running. So it's me, Polarized Raptor, and Fernando Prince. Now, I don't know who that is, but there's a person in front of us, there's a person behind us. Now, I have to get away. The person in front of us does not realize there's two people behind him, so hopefully the guy behind me will go inside that building and try to take him out and stop chasing me. That would be the dream. Now, there's a person in front of us. What are you doing, Raptor? Get behind me. I do not feel like fighting you. Okay, so, to be honest, we probably could have killed Raptor. The only part... that is some good stuff. I didn't even check my inventory. Now, let's hope no one hits me from the front, but let's go through this stuff. We have some very good stuff, guys. We have a good weapon. We have some mushroom stew for a little bit of regeneration. We have some amazing armor, some diamond pants. I guess the dude that we killed actually went inside the chest, grabbed things, and when he got out, I killed him, so I picked up his stuff. That is insane. So, we have three people left, Raptor, Polarized, and me. Now, I'm just gonna throw this stuff in the chest that we don't need, in case we pick up something during a fight that we're gonna need. Let's just throw all this stuff in there. Let's kind of make sure we don't need both either of those. So what we have in our inventory is we have the snowballs to keep someone away. I threw away the arrows because I don't have a bow. I threw away the boat because once we get into deathmatch, we're not gonna be near water. So what I'm gonna do is keep the two mushroom stews regeneration. Next is three types of food. Eggs and snowballs are to push people away, the fishing rods to push people away, and obviously my stone sword to kill people. So there's one person at spawn. Ooh, this is gonna be cheap. If this person doesn't notice me, I might kill them before deathmatch. This is so cheap. I am so sorry. 7 seconds until deathmatch. Not even one hit on me. Not even one hit. Ooh, I just turned this into a crispy 1v1. Now, ooh, Polarized is pretty good. I saw his stuff. This is not going to be an easy match. Now, hopefully, it's going to be a fair game. Let's see what's going to happen. Alright, so Polarized has a bow. Let's try to evade his bow. I did have arrows on me, but I don't have a bow, and that is one hit on me. It's a good thing I drank the mushroom stew, because that gives me a little bit of regeneration. I used my power, threw him behind me. Now he's shooting more arrows at me. What I have to do is bait out his arrows. If I can bait out his arrows, I can do a sword fight with him. But if he uses his arrows, I'm not going to survive. All right, he got a couple really good hits on me. A couple really good hits. Okay, so let's eat real quick so we can start regeneration again. Now, I don't know how much his food is, but he seems to be busy going throughout the chest, and I hit him a couple times with my sword. He did hit me with an arrow, so let's try to get at him. I don't think he's going to be doing that very long because that was dangerous on his part. Let's try to jump for him. He's going to be trying to shoot some arrows at me, but we got to go quickly. He's throwing some TNT. Let's throw him behind us, and boom. Okay, guys, let's get started with the next game. Now, the chests are kind of sketchy. I think I could still go for that one closest to us. Let's get started. Zero. Let's get running. Try to see if we can get something out of this chest. That was a good chest. That was a very good chest. We got a piece of armor that I can safely say is the best piece of armor anyone in this entire game will have. It is made out of iron, which is super rare to get, and it's a chest plate, so it gives us the most protection. That is a godly item, and we ended up also grabbing a weapon, which will help us massively if anyone tries to attack us, because obviously we can have a really good piece of armor, but if we have nothing to attack back with, we are gonna die. This dude, he tried to punch me. Where are you going? You know what, I think he might get away. Actually, we don't have enough speed on him. I think he might get away. I would love to kill him just because he tried to punch me. How rude is that? Just go find a person, first you tried to punch me, and then you try to steal the stuff out of my own chest. Get out of here. I don't want you near me. You are rude and mean. Alright, so there's 16 tributes left. A couple of them have died. There is some food and a helmet. We do not need the helmet. So far our armor, if we find some pants, we're going to be pristine because we have some amazing armor. We could find a better weapon. For sure, we could find a better weapon. If we find a stone sword or, dare I say, an iron sword or something, that would be insane. Of course, to get the iron sword, we'd have to get two iron and a stick. It wouldn't, nothing. I don't think you can get iron swords just out of chests. I don't think that's possible. You think you have to actually craft them. But we did get a bow out of that last chest, which could be very useful. Also some pants. Now those pants suck a lot, but they actually can help us. Any armor is some armor, so that's a good thing. Let's throw the trash in this chest. Gotta make sure there's no one behind us. Let's keep throwing the trash in here. And yeah, I don't think there's anyone near us for a long time, so I'm going to take my time here. There's nothing more important than an organized inventory, and I've learned that a lot. You might be able to win with a disorganized inventory, but honestly, I think the chances of people winning are much higher with an organized inventory because everything is just more organized. I don't know how to explain it. And when people die, you can pick up their stuff because you have a full inventory. Or if you die, some guy doesn't pick up your stuff. That's like too OP and, I don't know, share it with his friend or something. I don't know. But the point is, yeah, let's keep our inventory in shape and let's keep running around trying to find some things. Now we do have some materials to make some arrows and we do have a bow. So this might help us tremendously later on in the game. There are 12 tributes left, so about half have died. We have 4 minutes until chest refill, so we have plenty of time. We have 2 feathers, 5 flint, and 2 sticks, so that'll make us 8 arrows. If we can find some more sticks and feathers, we can make some more. But I'm just going to be honest, 8 is pretty good. We could kill somebody with 8. Let's grab this boat in case somebody ambushes us, and we can flee from the water with a boat. Those are always very useful, especially on this map. I do know where some water is on this map. I can just run straight to that water and have an escape route. Alright, let's grab as much food as possible. Also, you can never have enough food. Of course, if you have 1,000,000 apples, yeah, it's probably enough, but at this moment in time, I could use some more food. Always. There are 11 tributes left. Justin, the boss, has gotten killed. That is very, very sad. But, of course, for me to win, we will have to go through 10 people. Obviously, we don't have to kill all 10. They'll start killing each other at some point. But, yeah, guys, I'm feeling this game. We're doing pretty good thus far. I'm really feeling this game. If I can maybe find some better pants, maybe a better sword, I am really, really feeling this game. Now, I know there's a crafting table at spawn, so we gotta do this very, very, very quickly. If someone's behind me, they will kill me without a second thought. But we have managed to make ourselves some arrows. So that is pretty, pretty, pretty good. Let's keep running. Make sure if there's someone following us that we might be able to lose them or they might get bored. But it doesn't look like anyone's behind me, which is pretty good. There are 10 tributes left. 2.5 minutes until chest refill. And another person has died to a stone sword. Man, I really need to get myself one of those stone swords because those do help quite a lot, obviously. But maybe we can find a stone sword in one of these chests. I wouldn't doubt it. Maybe this one? Come on. No, of course those are empty. Someone probably looted them. But yeah. There seems like a lot of people have died there. That is some crazy stuff. Alright, that is some chain pants. That will help us quite a lot, actually. Thank you for those chain pants. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Let's run over here, see if we can grab anything, because I don't think we were here. A stick, that'll help us with not much. But let's just grab it. Maybe we'll use it for something. Let's see what else we can do. There's a person at spawn. Now, I think we can make more arrows. I don't know if we have the materials. I think we do. But even if we wanted to make them, there's someone. Actually, we do. Yeah, since we got that stick. But there's someone at spawn, so if I go there, I'll either have to get in a fight, kill them, and craft them, or I could just stay away in general. But now there's 2 people fighting over here. Hopefully they didn't see me and will turn around. Let's hope they don't. And one will turn around. So I am going to piece out of here very hard because I don't feel like fighting them. That dude has way better armor than me. And I think a stone sword too. But now we do have our own stone sword, which is very, very, very nice. Now this person is chasing me. Let's try to hit him with an arrow. No, so many arrows missed. Okay, there's 1 arrow. And yeah, let's keep trying to get her away from us. Let's use our power and run this. Let's see, can we pick up any other arrows? Alright, we gotta do that quickly. Oh, you threw your diamond axe at me. Why would you even do that? Let's try to hit him. Oh no, okay, let's run away. Let's run away. I don't feel like getting in a fight with you. That is some tense battles. Some arrows, lots and lots of missing of arrows and special power, and she threw her diamond axe at me. That would have been amazing if I could actually catch that, but sadly not. Let's grab this stuff and let's run into the water in case she's still chasing us. I don't know if she still is chasing us. Let's take a look, and it does not look like it, which is a good thing. That helps me a lot. Now let's look through the stuff we just picked up. I don't think there's going to be anything better in there, but yeah, let's take a look in a minute here. Let's get on land. Actually those boots will help us, but it doesn't look like there's nothing else. Chest refill in 1 second, let's check these chests. Now, the chances of us finding something that'll actually help us are kind of low right now because, we do have some good stuff in our inventory. Now, we have some amazing armor, we do have a really good weapon, but let's clear our inventory a bit. There's a guy there, let's not clear our inventory here, that's probably not a good idea. He will probably go around and try to hit me. Yep, that is exactly what he's done. Alright, we have 6 people left. Someone has a diamond axe. That one girl that tried to kill us. Yeah, I think it was that one. Now, I do want to clear off my inventory, but first we got to get rid of the guy behind me. Now, I'm going to use the old bait. Throw that person behind us. Hopefully them two will start fighting and I can get out of here. It's kind of like sacrificing a person, but oh well, it's a free-for-all. Everybody for themselves. I don't care if I sacrifice somebody, especially someone with good armor. That just gets rid of more competition. Now let's see what we can do. There's a I'm so sorry. I really don't like these types of kills where someone's just standing around with no armor, just minding their own business, and I just go up to them and wreck their faces. That's never fun. There are 5 people left. Kakuzi? I don't know how to say that. Lady Peppa, Diamond Steve, HQND, and of course me. So let's try to win, obviously. That is the point of this. Let's just dump all our stuff in here. I think this is a good place to dump. We gotta do this quickly because if someone's behind us or they know we're here, they will slaughter our faces, which is not any fun. That window's not gonna work. Let's go out this window. Let's throw that axe out of inventory. Of course, we don't need that. And we will just pick it right back up. But, this person right here doesn't notice we're there. But no, I'm so sorry, dude. You are going to die. I am so sorry. Oh, that is a kill. That is a very annoying kill. Okay, let's keep going. There are 3 people left. HQND, Kakuzi, still don't know how to say your name, and of course me. Now, I don't think this guy that we killed had anything better, but let's take a look. I think he had iron boots. It's actually a 1v1. You know what? I don't even have time to look because it's a 1v1. Let's try to hit him. Let's try to hit him. Is this going to be a kill? Oh, no, no, no. What is it? What were those hits? Oh, did you guys see those hits? That is some cheeky hits. What was that? That was some cheeky hits. Okay, let's see what we can do. It doesn't look like we can really upgrade much. Now, that was... ooh, I don't know what that was. Now, hopefully if I get anywhere near her, she won't do that again. Because if she does that again, I'm going to be saying some things I don't want to say. I don't want to be saying some words, but I might have to. Starts with an H, ends with an R. But anyway, let's... oh, what are these hits? What are these hits? Are you... okay, well, it's a good thing we're going in the deathmatch. But the thing is, those hits were... ooh, I don't know. I don't want to say the H word that ends with an R. But I'm some hacker. I don't know. I hate calling it, but wow, those were some fishy hits. Those were some fishy hits. Now, we do have a lot of arrows in our bow. Hopefully, we can maybe take her out with an arrow. Actually, we don't have arrows. We actually have to craft them. I completely forgot. Please don't hit me. Please don't hit me. Oh, we got the arrows. She hit us once, but we do have the arrows. Let's try to eat. She might hit us one more time, but with eating, that'll give us some regeneration. Let's try to hit her with some arrows. We have plenty of arrows now. I really shouldn't miss them, though. That might cost me the game. Okay, let's pick up this arrow out of here. Let's keep trying to hit her. I don't want to get near her because it's pretty obvious that if I go in a 1v1 fight with her, she is going to hit me very far back and I am not going to survive. So let's try to kill her with a bow. I might end up having to use my power to kill her though. We can see her at, and I miss. No, why do I suck with bows so much? That's 4 hits. That's 5, 4 or 5. I forgot my count. Okay, look, we got to go in after her. Let's use our power. Let's hit her, hit her, hit her, hit her. Oh no, and yeah, okay, we're going to have to back up. The only problem is now I'm out of arrows. That's going to do me some damage because now I'm going to have to get close to her. But look at her hits. Her hits are insane. Why does she hit so far? Are you kidding me? Does she have some special class that does that? I don't think so. I don't think they have a hacker class on Mindplex. But there is one arrow. I think that is a second arrow. I don't know if we picked that up. Let's try to go get her. I know she's at low health because we've hit her plenty of times. Let's go. One. Missed. Two. Missed. All right, let's try to maybe use our power to bring her in and try to kill her. The border is getting quite close. One, two, three, four, five. Come on, come on, come on. And bam. Well, guys, those were two very exciting games. I called hacks in both games. I hate doing that. Today was a hacker special, apparently. Or there might be no such thing as hackers. You guys tell me in the comments. Tell me if I'm wrong. Hopefully I'm wrong. I want to be wrong, to be honest, because I don't want to think that people are hacking. That's just no fair and no fun. But we did end up winning both games, which is actually insane. Now, guys, I had a lot of fun today. Hopefully you guys had a lot of fun watching. And if you did, make sure to like and comment as it supports my channel. And I'll see you guys later. God bless and goodbye.